Good morning, children. So today we are moving on to our third chapter, that is subtraction. Okay? In the previous classes, we have learned addition with regrouping and without regrouping as well. So today it is subtraction with regrouping and without regrouping. Okay? So before moving on to the topic, have a look at this question. This means we have to subtract 35 from 47. Okay? So here 47 is the bigger number and 35 is the smaller one. Okay? So usually we subtract a smaller number from a bigger number. Okay? So how will you start to subtract? We'll start from the ones place as usual. So 7 minus 5. How will you do 7 minus 5? Keep the second number in mind and count till this number comes. That is 5 in mind, 6, 7, till 7. Okay? So the answer is 2. So the answer is 2. Now moving on to tens place. 4 minus 3. 4 minus 3. That is easy, right? 4 minus 3 is 1. So here we got the answer as 12. Here we got answer as 12. So, listen children, here 47 and 35 are the two numbers that we are using in subtraction and the answer is 12. Here, this first number is called monument. The first number is called what? Monument. And the second one is called subtrahend. Second one is called subtrahend. The first number is called monument. The second one is called subtrahend. And the answer is called difference. Okay? And the answer is called difference. Monument, subtrahend, difference. Okay? So this is the thing that you have to keep in mind first. Okay? Moving on. Subtraction of three-digit numbers. Okay? Similar to addition, we will be learning subtraction also of three-digit numbers. So, have a look at this question, children. So now, 837 minus 325. So here, 837 is the bigger number and 325 is the smaller one. So what we are going to do? Yes, we are going to subtract 325 from 837. So, how will you start? We'll start from the ones place. 7. 7 minus 5. 7 minus 5. What is the answer? Yes, it is 2. Okay? Then coming back to tens place. Coming to tens place. 3 minus 2. What is 3 minus 2? It is 1. What is 3 minus 2? It is 1. So, the answer is 1. And now, 8 minus 3. What is 8 minus 3? 8 minus 3 is? Yes, 5. So here we got the answer. What is the answer? 512. What is the answer? 512 is the answer. Okay? So this is an example for subtraction without regrouping. Okay? That means we haven't done any grouping in this sum. Okay? So now, moving on to the next number. So try to spell this number, children. Yes, 894 minus 238. 894 minus 238. So this is the bigger one. So we'll start from ones place. We'll start from ones place. Okay? So I'll write it just above. Okay? So now 4 minus 8. 4 minus 8. Is it possible to subtract 8 from 4? 4 is a smaller one. number. So what we'll do? Yes, we will be taking or we will be borrowing a number from the next place value. Okay, we will be borrowing a number from the next place value. What will be the number? The number will be 1. Okay, so when it comes to this one, that is when it comes to a situation where we got a smaller number here and we got a bigger number here, what we'll do? Yes, we will be taking or borrowing a 1 from the next place value. Here the next place value is what? 10. So here we are taking 1 from here. Okay, we are taking 1 from here and this becomes what? 14. This becomes what? 14. Here we already have a 4 and a 1 from here it becomes 14. Okay, now is it possible to subtract 14 minus 8? Yes, it is possible, right? It is the bigger number and this is the smaller one. So how will you subtract 14 minus 8? How will you do this? Yes, 8 in mind and we have to count till 14 comes. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14. Yes, the answer is what? The answer is 6. Okay, now coming back to this number. We have given 1, right? So 9 minus 1 gives what? 8. Okay, we have already given a 1 to the next number. So the remaining is what? 8. From 9 we have given 1. So the remaining will be 8. 9 minus 1 will be 8. So now instead of 9, we are having 8. Okay, so 8 minus 3. 8 minus 3. What is 8 minus 3? It is 5. Okay, now here we have done nothing. So as usual, 8 minus 2. What is 8 minus 2? Yes, 6. This is the answer. So what we have done here? Yes, first we have started our subtraction from 1's place. So here 4 is in 1's place and here 8 is in 1's place. So we are doing what? 4 minus 8. So we found it difficult to subtract 8 from 4. So what we have done? We have taken or we have borrowed a 1 from the next place value. So this number becomes 14. Then 14 minus 8 gives 6. Okay, after giving 1, 9 becomes 8. And 8 minus 3 gives 5. And again here we have done nothing. So 8 minus 2 gives 6. Clear, children? Now, this is about what? Subtraction with regrouping. This is called subtraction with regrouping. Now have a look at this question. Okay. So we are starting from 1's place. 2 minus 1. So we found it difficult to subtract 7 from 2. So we will be borrowing a 1 from the next place value. So what will this number become? 12. It becomes 12 because already we have a 2 here, we have taken 1. So the answer is 12. So 12 minus 7. What is 12 minus 7? 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. The answer is 5. Okay, so we will write 5 here. Okay, now we have given a 1 from 4. We have given a 1 from 4. So 4 minus 1 is 3. So here we have a remaining number 3. So instead of 4 we are having 3. 3 minus 5. 3 minus 5. Again we found it difficult to subtract 5 from 3. So again what we will do? Yes, we will be borrowing a number 1 from the next place value. A number 1 from the next place value. Which is the next place value here? Hundreds. So we will be taking 1 from this 7 to make this 3 13. So we are taking 1 from here and this number becomes 13. Okay, and this number becomes 13. Here we are already at 3 and 1 becomes 13. Okay, what you have to notice here is here we have a 3 and when 1 comes, this becomes 13, not 4. Okay, this becomes 13. You have to remember that. Now, is it possible to subtract 13 minus 5? 8. Okay, now here, after giving out 1, 7 becomes 6. So 6 minus 4 is what? 2. So the answer is 285. So this is how you do subtraction with regrouping. Okay children, this is how you do subtraction with regrouping. Now we have discussed and learned on 3-digit numbers. But what about 4-digit numbers? Yes, there is no difference between the subtraction of 3-digit and 4-digit numbers instead of the number of digits. Okay children, so I'll tell you what. Let's have an example on 4-digit numbers. Okay, so now ones place, tens place, hundreds place, thousands place. We have 4-digit numbers. Okay. So now starting from ones place. 0 minus 9. 0 minus 9. Is it possible? No. So what we will do? We will be borrowing a number that is 1 from the next place value. Okay. Which is the next place value here? Yes, it is tens. So we will be taking a 1 from this place value. So when here is already a 0, when 1 comes it becomes 10. When 1 comes it becomes 10. And what about here? We have given a 1. So this becomes 4. This becomes 4. Now 10 minus 9, it is 1. It is very easy, right? 1. Now 4 minus 6. Here we have 4 minus 6. Is it possible? Yeah, no. Because, yes, what we have to do? We have to take a 1 from this place value. Right? So we are already having a 1 here. So we are taking this 1 to the next place value. So here, instead of 4, it becomes 14. Instead of 4, it becomes 14. And what about here? We were having 1 here. After giving out 1, 1 minus 1 gives 0. 0. There is nothing here. 0. Okay. Now is it possible? 14 minus 6. Yes. What is 14 minus 6 children? What is 14 minus 6? 6 in mind and count till 14. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14. So the answer is 8. Okay. Now moving on. 0 minus 8. Again 0 is a small number and 8 is a bigger number. What we have to do? Yes, we have to again borrow a number from the next place value. We have to borrow a 1 from the next place value. So here we are already having a 0 and the 1 comes here and it becomes 10. And here we have taken a 1 from 7 and this becomes 6. Okay, now 10 minus 8 gives 2. And what about 6 minus 5? 6 minus 5 is 1. So the answer is 1281. The answer is 1281. So just have a look at this question children. We were having 2 4-digit numbers and we subtracted 5869 from 7150. So what we have done here? We have done subtraction with regrouping. When a smaller number and a bigger number comes, when we find difficult to subtract two numbers, what we will do? We will take a 1 from the next place value. Okay children? So, hope you understand this concept. And moving on to the next topic is addition and subtraction together. Addition and subtraction together. What do you mean by together? Yes, both. We have to do both the addition and subtraction. So in your textbook, take page number 49 and page number 49, you are having a topic addition and subtraction together and they have given an example also. Okay? So the question is 669 plus 180 minus 472 plus 233. So they have given this. So this is the question. So what we have to do is addition and subtraction together. Here we have addition, subtraction, addition. Okay, so what we have to do? We have to do them together. So to make it more easier, what we will do is, first we will add these two numbers. Okay, so we know addition, so it is very easy to add these two numbers. So after adding these numbers, what will be the answer? Have a look at the textbook. Yes, it is 849. Okay, now this portion is over. We have got the answer 849. Now what we have to do? -472. Okay, so 849 - 472. Got it, children? First we have done the addition and we have got a new answer, that is the sum. And then we will subtract this number from the sum because here is a minus. Okay, so 849 - 472. And again we get the answer, right? What will be the answer? Have a look at the textbook. It is 377. It is 377. And what is the remaining portion here? Plus 233. So we will be adding this. Right? We will be adding these two numbers. 377 plus 233. And then we will get the answer 610, which is the final answer of this question. Okay? So when it comes like this, there is addition and subtraction together, we have to move from here to here. First we will do this part, and then we will do this part, and then we will do this part. Okay? Clear? Now, there is one more topic for today's session, that is checking out the answers. Checking out the answers. So, in the same page, that is page number 49, have a look at the topic. Checking subtraction through addition. Okay? So, we are checking the answer, whether the answer is right or wrong. So, how will you do that? Have a look at the example number 9. Subtract 366 from 981 and check the answer. So, what you have to do is subtract 366 from 981. Okay? So, 981 minus 366. So, what you will get? You get the answer as 615. You get the answer as 615. So, we have to check whether this answer is right or wrong using addition. So, what you will do is, this is the answer you get. Right? Or this is the difference we got. This is the difference we got. So we will take this difference, that is 615, and we will add this to the second number over here. What is the second number over here? It is called subtrahend. Okay? What is it called? Subtrahend. So we will add the difference to the subtrahend. And then we will get the same answer. So 5 plus 6 gives 11, 1 and a 1 here, 1 plus 1 plus 6, it is 8, and 6 plus 3 is 9. So we got the same monument. Alright, so how will check the answer? First we will do the subtraction and we take the sum or difference. Okay, we take this answer and then we will add this answer to the subtrahend, that is the second number. Okay, we will take this one and we will add this second number. And what will be the answer? We will get the same answer as the monument. Okay, this is how you check your answers using addition. Okay, so first we will do the subtraction and then we will take the difference and we will be adding the difference to the second number or subtrahend and we will get the answer. And the answer will be same as the monument. So this is how you check your answers. Okay. So far we have discussed about subtraction with and without regrouping, addition and subtraction together, and checking subtraction through addition. So what you have to do is, in page number 44, you are having an exercise 3.1. The first question in your exercise, try to do it yourself and we will be discussing the answers in the interactive session. Okay? And the second question, I will be giving you notes. And moving on to second exercise. There are three questions over there. The first and second questions are related to the topics that we have discussed today. That is addition and subtraction together and checking the answers. I'll be giving you the notes. So what you have to do as practice work is the first question in each of the exercises 3.1, 3.2 and the complete exercise 3.3. The rest I'll be giving you the notes and we'll be discussing the answers of these exercises in the interactive session. Thank you.